some of the questions comes that what is the difference between the Automata class and the compiler class. I have already answered that compiler class only looks towards deterministic context-free grammar. Why deterministic context-free grammar? Because any programming has to be parsed. It has to be parsed, and this parsing complexity matters. So for linear grammar, the parsing complexity ON, and the context-free grammar complexity is ON cube. But with clever manipulation, with clever selection, we can make it ON. And for other grammars, like context-sensitive grammars, like where the left-hand side, a variable can have another terminal or variable, and there the parsing, by no way it can be done ON. So it will be NP complete problem. You know, NP complete problem complexity is much greater than N cube. I have given what is NP complete problem. NP complete problem means you cannot solve the problem directly very easily, but if you are given the solution, you can quickly check it there. Okay, this is NP complete problem. So it's a very tough nature of problem. Then context sensitive grammar is no for our programming purpose. And why we need programming? Because we have to do certain steps again and again by the function call. And because of the, you have to call the function call repeated again and again, you need a stack. So whenever you are calling from a function, you save it to a stack and call another function. Then if you another function call, then you again that save it on the stack. So it is a recursion, you already know. So every time this function call is very essential. And another reason for context-free grammar is if-then-else structures. If-then-else or if-then-else. Else should go to the nearest then. So all these things you need the second bracket of your bracket opening and closing, and it has to be matched. You know, the finite-state machine or regular grammar cannot do that. So we have to go for this context-free grammar. And not only context-free grammar, it is deterministic context-free grammar. And not only deterministic context-free, it's a subset of deterministic context-free grammar where you can have unambiguous grammar. You know what is unambiguous grammar and ambiguous language. And not only unambiguous grammar, it has to be either LL1 or LR1. Remember what is LL1 grammar is. LL1 grammar is you can from the start symbol S, you can reach to the your string of symbols, string of terminals by of the first symbol. That is LL1, and there we have no certain restrictions because it cannot back and forth. If it's a back and forth, that is a brute force top down technique. It is absolutely no because the complexity will be greater than ON, because ideally we should always want it should be ON. So we have to have predictive parser. Predictive parser means you looking at the first terminal, you can guess 100% correct that which rule to be used. Then you have to calculate the parsing table. The parsing table is nothing but top columns are the terminals, and left hand side will be all the symbols, and left hand side symbols comes on the top of the stack, and every terminal there are only one and only one rule. That is called parsing table. It can be generated by a program. It can be generated by human being, by programmers, because top-down parsing very easy. Yes, that is the summary I have told, and whatever we have covered today. And we also know how to calculate the first and follow. This is very, very essential for any parsing. So that is the mechanical thing, how to give a first piece, what are the terminals will come. The first is always for not for terminal. First of a terminal is always a terminal. First of it, all variables, and first of it, all right hand string. We know that what is the restriction of context free grammar. Yes. So we are basically into the parsing. What is parsing? Basically, we know that we are parsing for the deterministic context free unambiguous grammar. The reason I have told you, and lexical analysis. Before that is the lexical analysis, and I have already told you 99% case lexical analysis is a separate stage, so that you can take the tokens. And what are the process? You have the tokens. It is basically lots of finite state irregular expressions are working on. So they select the integer, floating point, tokens, and all these things, and they get strings. So your program is basically, whenever you write a program, a 10-line program, say include standard io.h, blah blah blah, and the main comment lines. So they take the syntax analyzer, taken out the all the comment lines, white spaces, and they give the tokens and a string of tokens. So initially it's a string of tokens. So now the role of, now there can be some, and it is partially filling the symbol table. You know, the symbol table fully filling up will be done by mainly parsing and then the semantic stages, and this is the analysis phase. And parsing main idea is after your lexer or you get the strings, and you have to see whether that is a valid string or not. That is the thing. Not only that, your decision problems, whether it's valid, is then you have to generate the parsing tree or abstract syntax tree. And what is the difference between parsing tree and abstract syntax tree? I have told number of times, but anytime, abstract syntax tree is nothing but where the operations at the node and leaf is the your operands. So that's it. And if the abstract syntax tree should be unique, if you traverse it from left to right, and it should be same when the right to left. Left to right is the top down parsing, and the top down parsing, we know the problem will be if we have the backtrack, there is, we should avoid backtrack, and that is one thing. There should be no backtrack, because if it's a backtrack, it cannot be when, and not only that, you can backtrack maybe at arbitrary level, maybe from 99 stages you have to backtrack at 12 stages. So there is a inordinate time of complexity of the storage complexity, and program go hangs. So that is the reason, no backtracking. So it's a predictive parser. So it should be recursive predictive parser. Predictive parser means it, you can always predict correct 100%. So what is the rule of predictive parser? That is, your grammar should be no backtracking, and another restriction is that there will no left factoring, no left recursion should be there. If any grammar has a left recursion, there will be always a recursive grammar. Recursive top-down grammar is always give might error. So recursion should not be there. So we know that how to remove the recursion, left recursion, by simple changing of the variable. We'll show it today itself. Then it is also may not be top-down grammar. Then you have to calculate the first of all variables and first of all right-hand expression, and we have to see that first should be shy. There should be, so seeing that only one terminal, you can detect the which rule. Then you have to fill it up a parsing table. The parsing table, the top will be the all your top side will be all your terminals. All terminals are left hand side should be all your variables, and you should have a stack, and initially you fill the stack with a start symbol S, and the top is a Q, and there's a string which has to be parsed, and then we match with the left side of the string with the S. Then we see which rule to be fired, and then we take out that S, and corresponding right hand side should be pushed into the stack. Again you see, and we take out the left terminal, right, here's left terminal also. Then we also see then which variable or terminal here now in the stack, it can be variables and terminals. Then we can check which can match, and the rule should be one and only one, the parsing table. That is the LL1 parsing table. Today we will check the LL1 parsing table and see this is why LL1 is a left to right leftmost derivation. We'll cover LR later. Any confusion you can say. So that is, we have already covered top down, backtracking absolutely no, because it's go haywire. predictive parsing, we are now focusing it. It should be 100%. Then you say, sir, predictive parsing is very easy to understand. Why you go for bottom up parsing? I have already number of times told you the predictive parsing extra thing. You have to remove the left recursion. The left recursion is not at a problem at a bottom up parsing, and right recursion also not at a problem at bottom up parsing. And so that is the, and also range of LL1 grammar is much less than LR1. And so we'll choose for a bottom-up parsing. But for understanding bottom-up parsing, we have to understand that predictive parsing, LL1 parsing, for better understanding for this one. But right now, LL1 parsing also used in many cases. It is very simple parser. Parser is faster. So that's it. So let's go to the directly. I already explained to you, say this is certain kind of unambiguous grammar. We definitely for this unambiguous grammar, not all every unambiguous grammar you can parse, and we are forgetting our LL0 and LR0. We should at least one look ahead. So this is the LL1 range, this is the LL1 and this is the LR1 range, though it is not drawn according to the scale, but really LR1 range is much bigger than LL1. So most of the grammar is LR1, and if you take look ahead for 1 to 2, you can get a greater range, not that greater, and parsing table will be huge. That I already told you. I think this will be always this grammar number of times in many books will cover again and again. In first grammar you have seen E plus E, and here E plus P forward slash E, and it is E star E E E end. But what is the problem there? That is called the expression grammar. Then the problem will be ambiguity, because we want to calculate the multiplication first, so we introduce T here. So this is a T star F. So any expression, say 3 plus 2 star 7, that 2 star 7 will be calculated first if we put this rule. So anyhow, anyone, any misunderstanding, tell me. So this is a modified rule of E plus E forward alternative E, E star E. This is a modified rule, so that I do not want that unambiguous. So make it to unambiguous grammar too, because multiplication will be always done first. This is the expression grammar. To make that ambiguous grammar to unambiguous grammar, we change the rule. This is a famous grammar. I am taking this grammar as an example, and whether it is a can you tell me whether it is a fit for LL1? It cannot be, because you see left recursion is there, E, and again E is there, T is there. So it is a left recursive. So I have to change the rule. I have to make it as a top down LL1 parsing. So next, go to the next slide. So this has the change. This is original grammar. After removal of left recursion, we make it like this rule, another E dash, so, and another T dash. By E dash and T dash, and E dash and T dash can go to epsilon. This grammar is same as this grammar. We take it like this, like T to T dash, T to T star F. We make to T to here F T. You are making to because no left recursion, star F should be there. So we make this T dash to epsilon and make it to star F T dash. So you remove this. This rule T star F becomes this rule. T F T dash, F can go epsilon, T dash can go to epsilon or F T dash. Anyone any doubt? I have changed these two rules. E, say take the example E is equal to E plus T T. So this rule cannot be there. I must put it plus T E dash. This rule is plus T E dash and E dash to epsilon, and this is the rule T E dash. So there is no left recursion. So this first rule is changed into two rules, and this rule changed to two rules. So there is three rules, right now five rules. This first rule, by removing left recursion, I get it and another extra symbol E dash, so that it cannot be on the left side, and E dash can go to epsilon and E dash can go to plus dE dash. So I can get this. This is the three rules, and we extend this to two more rules to remove repercussion. Now, we have to create the parsing table. So this is your new modified rule. This is your original rule. You change it to modified rule without left recursion. So this rule, now your working rule is this. Now you have to calculate all the first calculation. See, first of e, what should be the first of e? It should be first of t dash. It should be first of t. So what is the first of t here? First of f, and first of f is single bracket opening. First of f is single bracket opening, and another rule is int. First of f is beginning open bracket or int. So first of e is a set of beginning open bracket int. Now first of t dash, what can be the first of t dash? C is the rule here, t dash. The first of t dash is simple, star. It is a star, but it can go to epsilon, so epsilon should be there. So you calculate like this. First of e dash is plus, and it can go to epsilon, so epsilon here. First of t dash, it should be star and epsilon. First of t dash, yes, star and epsilon, we already there. And what is first, we have all calculated. And remember, we don't have to calculate first of terminals. Now we see the follow of these things. Follow is very essential for top bottom up parsing also. First is also there, follow is very essential. I will tell you why follow is very essential, because when there is an error, then the follow will tell you at which point you are error. Okay, so let's see what is follow of e. See, always that we started from e, follow of e should be always dollar. So follow of e is equal to follow of e dash. Follow of e, definitely follow of e dash, and it will be definitely, you can see it here, dollar. It can be dollar or it can be bracket ends. How can you get it? Follow of e, follow of e is always dollar. The follow here, see, follow. So e is followed by this bracket ends. So follow of e should be dollar and bracket ends. Similarly, follow of t, see here, follow of t, what can be happens? Follow of t goes where? T, follow of t is first of e dash. First of e dash is plus and epsilon. So follow of t is dollar should be and plus. You check it. Okay, any time you have confusion, follow of t. The follow of t equals to after anything which comes after t. Follow of t is follow of t dash. Follow of t dash epsilon will be always there. Okay. Follow of t dash epsilon will be always there. Then where are the t dash is? It is the t dash, and definitely dollar will be there. Okay, because first of e dash epsilon, so dollar will be there. So you just calculate, everything will be there. Now we have to create the parsing table. This is very, very important, nothing, very easy. Here you see the top side, you put the terminals, and left hand side you put your variables. And here all the first, not follow. Here you check it, what I have told, what should be the LL1 grammar rules. You know, the first of the right hand side should be unique, and if the first of any variable is epsilon, then first of that and follow of this should be shy. Okay. So that is the rule of the LL1 grammar, and here I am using only first. Say in example, if you see E here, E, and first of E comes here int. Now with first of E and int, which rule? You look it here, with which rule, you see this is the rule. E to T dash. This only rule comes into this. There are no other rule you can have So E have, how many rules are there? E has only one rule, T dash. So you can E to T dash, say T, T, what can it can go? T, it can go to INT. How we can see? T to E dash, T dash, okay? Now, here, T to E dash, and now you see it here, T to, T can go to FT dash, and F can goes to INT. F can goes to INT. So that is the thing, only one rule. You check this, then all this, only one rule it come. I'll try to on board one day. Next day I'll go on board, but I'll give all the documents. This is what I am saying, it is correct. The next slide is very interesting. It is, hope so it is. So if you have a string like this, INT plus INT star INT, then you, this is the parsing stack. Here you put the star symbol. Here star symbol is E. In most of the cases in S, you put S into it, and I have told you the top thing is the, you put it here, and now look at this, and look at this only. You try to predict from this table which rule to fire. Now this rule is fired, and now what is the condition? Then E should be taken out, and the T E dash should be pushed into. Now you have to match, and nothing, no change in input, because then you have to match T with INT. Now T with INT is equal to T FT dash. Now this rule, predict T is equal to FT dash. This is the way ultimately the parsing, this E will be vanished, and the remaining input will be vanished. If both condition are true, your parsing matches. Okay, the, all the things are there. So just summarily, it is maybe not be not easy to look at it. I'm already on the ma'am class is there. I just, whatever we have done, I'm just telling you once more. This is expression grammar. Expression grammar modified. Because to make it an unambiguous grammar, expression grammar is earlier E plus E, alternative E, E star, E, forward slash E, Bacchus-Naur form. But that creates an ambiguity. The multiplication can happen earlier. So that multiplication should come first. So I am incorporating T. T is equal to T star F. With this modification, you can get it a unambiguous grammar, which is good for bottom-up parsing. This is excellent for bottom-up parsing, but it is not fit for top-down parsing. Why? Because E and E, left recursion, T and T, left recursion. So I changed these two rules to E to T dash, and E dash goes to plus T dash epsilon. If you see, these two rules is nothing but this one rule. I am removing left recursion of E. Similarly, T to T star F and F, we can make these two rules. So this is now the modified rule, and now it looks that it is not a left recursion and unambiguous, but you are not sure. How to make it sure? I have to calculate all the first of all variables and first of all this, and we'll check that whenever you are parsing, the first of all right hand side. See, look at here. First of all, right hand side will be distinct symbol. So this string, first will be opening bracket, here first should be star, here first should be first of F. What should be the first of F? First of F definitely will be different. Here is another plus. So all first is different. So we calculate this, then we create this parsing table. The parsing table, nothing but top side will be the all the terminals, and left hand side all the variables. And looking at the variables, like we put the start variable at here E into the stack first, and all the parsing to be done on the top of the on the input string Q. It will not back and forth, everything will be deterministic. So here we because of seeing it S or E, it here because E, we put the rule T E dash into the stack. Then try to match E dash, try to match like we put here like T E dash. Now we try to match the next this thing to this. Okay, so this is ultimately by reducing, it will be dollar, you will be taken, and your bottom up person will discuss. Bottom up person will start with dollar and will finish with E, right? This way. And here top down person, we are going this way, but bottom up person will go to reverse this way by reducing, but that will be much tougher algorithm. So we'll discuss.